morning students. This session is for class 11 physics. Our topic is units and measurements. In this part, first topic is physical quantities, then second one is fundamental quantities, third one is fundamental units, fourth one is derived quantities, fifth derived units, and then supplementary quantities and their units. Students, these are the most important basic topic of this part. So we are going to start physical quantities in detail, then fundamental quantities and their units. Students, our topic is physical quantities. Actually, physical quantities are those quantities which can be measured directly or indirectly in terms of physical laws that can be expressed. Okay? It means physical quantities are that physical quantities, means physical quantities are those quantities which can be measured directly or indirectly. Okay? But the point is in terms of physical laws which can be expressed. For example, mass of a body, then mass is a physical quantity. Okay? Length of the body, then length is a physical quantity, force, temperature. And you will see in different physical laws we will use these physical quantities. It means physical quantities are the base of the physical laws. Okay, we can say physical quantities are the basic, or physical quantities are the base of the physical laws. Okay, we will discuss this in later. Student, before studying fundamental quantity, let us understand what is meaning of measurement. So student, measurement is a comparative process. Okay, measurement is actually a comparison. Okay, suppose I am giving you one example. Suppose this one is one object. Okay, we say we want to find out its weight. Okay, so how we can find out its weight? We need some weight for weighing this. So suppose I have something different. Okay, now I try to compare weight of these two, and I say this is quite lighter than this one, this one is heavier than the marker. Now I have another. Suppose I took these two, okay, and this one is one. Now if roughly if these two are equal, then we can say the weight of this one is twice of any one of the marker. So we compare weight of this one with this marker. So this one is a measurement. It means I compared weight of this object with these two markers. So this one is a measurement. We can also find out length of this marker with the help of this charger. Suppose I want to find out length of this marker, then we can measure once at this point, then twice, and it is half. Roughly we can say that length of this one is 2.5 times length of this. So this one is a comparison. This process is known as measurement. In measurement, we try to write the fundamental quantity in mathematical term, or we want to find out the value, numerical value of the fundamental quantity. Okay, so measurement is a comparison actually. Okay, measurement is a comparison of the physical quantity with some standard unit. Okay, so this process is known as measurement. Now we are going to find out, or we are going to understand what is the fundamental quantities. Students, physical quantities which are independent of other physical quantities are called fundamental quantities. Students, fundamental quantities are independent. It means they are not related to any other physical quantity. There is no need to express fundamental quantities in terms of other physical quantity. Okay, they cannot be expressed. They have their own own value. Okay, they are not related with other physical quantity like mass. Mass is independent of length, time, temperature, electric current, etc. Similarly, length is independent on time, temperature, electric current. So you can see these examples. These are examples of the fundamental quantity. These are completely independent from each other. So there are total 7 fundamental quantity. First one is mass, second length, you can write first, then second, third time, fourth temperature, fifth electric current, then the sixth one is luminous intensity, seventh one is quantity of matter. Okay, so this one is 7. So let me repeat the things. Fundamental quantities are those quantities which are independent from any other physical quantity. Okay, they, in this example you can see mass is independent of time, length, temperature, electric current, luminous intensity, quantity of matter. Similarly, quantity of matter is independent from other 6. Okay, so this is known as fundamental quantity. And measurement is a comparison of the physical quantity with any standard. जो भी स्टैंडर्ड बनाया गया है, उस जैसे कि हम लोग लेंथ मेजर करने के लिए मीटर स्केल का यूज करते हैं, या फिर सेंटीमीटर यूज कर सकते हैं, मिलीमीटर यूज कर सकते हैं, ये स्टैंडर्ड यूनिट्स है। इनसे ही जैसे इसकी लेंथ हमें मेजर करना है तो सेंटीमीटर स्केल से इसको कंपेयर करेंगे, चेक करेंगे इसकी लेंथ कितनी है। जैसे अभी अभी हमने एग्जाम्पल लिया था, इससे इस ये वंस देन ट्वाइस एंड इट इज क्वाइट 2.5। This one is a rough result actually. So measurement is a comparison. Okay. So pause this video and note it down. So students, we completed fundamental quantities. Now our topic is fundamental units. The units used to measure fundamental quantities are called fundamental units. Okay. It means to measure fundamental quantities, we have some units and that units are known as fundamental quantities. For example, unit of mass is kilogram. So student, you can see mass is a fundamental quantity. Now we need some unit to measure this mass. Then this one is unit, this kilogram is unit, this one is unit. And this unit kg is used to measure mass. It means fundamental quantity. So this unit is known as fundamental unit. It means units which are used to measure fundamental quantities are known as fundamental units. Okay, so this one example. Now I am going to write down the 7 fundamental quantities and their units in a table. Okay, so students, in this table you can see fundamental quantities and their units that are known as basic or fundamental units. Okay, the first fundamental quantity is mass and its unit is kilogram. In short, you can write kg. Okay, second one is length, or you can say distance. Its unit is meter. In short, you can say m. Third one is time, its unit is second, in short you can write S. Fourth one is temperature, unit of temperature is Kelvin. Students, degree Celsius is also unit of temperature, but in standard, in SI format, Kelvin is unit of temperature. Fifth one is electric current. Electric current is a fundamental quantity. Its unit is ampere, in short you can write A. Sixth one is luminous intensity. Luminous intensity, unit of luminous intensity is candela, right, CD. And last one is quantity of matter. Unit of this one is mole. In short, you can write M1. So you can see in this table, 7 units, these 7 quantities are independent to each other, so that they are known as fundamental quantities. And in this table here, you can see the basic units of these seven fundamental quantities. This table is very important for further study. So the next topic is derived quantities. Students, physical quantities which are defined in terms of fundamental quantities are called fundamental quantities, are called derived quantities. Okay, it means derived quantities are those quantities which are defined or which are derived from fundamental quantities. Okay, these derived quantities are defined in terms of fundamental quantity. For example, area. You can see area contains length into length. It means area is related to length. So this one is derived quantity. Similarly, density. Density is equal to mass upon volume. Now volume is related to length. So you can see density related to mass upon volume, and volume is related to length. So these densities related to are defined from fundamental quantity. So these type of physical quantities which are defined from fundamental quantities are known as derived quantities. Now derived units. This one is derived unit. Units used to measure derived quantities are called derived units. For example, since you can see this one is derived quantity, so derived unit of area, it means unit of area is equal to meter square. So this meter square is derived unit and area is derived quantity. So unit which measures derived quantity are known as derived unit. You can write unit of density, velocity, force, volume. Similarly for force, you can write, for force unit is Newton. Newton is a derived unit. Similarly for volume, you can write meter cube. So you can see this meter cube measures derived unit, this volume is derived unit. So this one is, this volume is derived quantity, so this meter cube is derived unit.